Without a doubt, the Allagash Wilderness Waterway in northern Maine rates as the brightest among the jewels of Maine's wilderness state parks and historic sites. Some 104 miles end-to-end, the waterway offers the canoer both lake and river paddling environments, including primitive camping, portages, class 2 whitewater paddling on 5-mile chase rapids, 40-foot Allagash Falls, and remnants of the century-old Eagle Lake tramway built to aid transporting logs to the paper mills. The pictures and videos in this film are a composite of 3 Allagash trips guided by Loon Parsons. Hello, this is Outdoor Steve. This presentation has 4 parts. First, meet the film stars, the Loon and the Chickadee, and the 15 paddles they guided on 3 separate week-long adventures of Allagash insight, history lessons, teaching, paddling skills, and the peace of the remote North Country called the Allagash Wilderness Waterway. Second, watch the briefs from the trips to get insight into the verses sung in the Allagash ballad. See our paddlers do a canoe rescue for 2 of our group in the middle of Eagle Lake. See father-son combinations run the hazards and remnants of Long Lake Dam. Hear why Folger's black silk is forever cherished. Next, hear Tim's interview on his 7 trips in Maine with the Loon and the Chickadee, and memories to be heard in the Ballad of the Allagash. Finally, this is the Ballad of the Allagash, sung to Janis Joplin's melody, "Oh Lord, Won't You Buy Me," in Mercedes Benz. All the verses are composed by individuals who experienced paddling the Allagash Wilderness Waterway with Master Maine Guide Loon and his wife, the Chickadee. Each stanza of the ballad reflects a special Allagash moment. Happy and safe paddling, and never say I wish I had paddled the Allagash Wilderness Waterway, and thus sections 12 and 13 of the Northern Forest Canoe Trail. The map here shows in red the 3 put-ins, 1 at Johnson Pond and 2 at Indian Stream. Our takeouts are at St. John River in Allagash Village, Maine, near the New Brunswick-Canadian border. Johnson Pond was a 104-mile, 8-day paddle, and Indian Stream, a 94-mile, 6-day paddle. The blue arrows are the northern paddling's downstream route. The Allagash also serves as the easternmost section of the 740-mile Northern Forest Canoe Trail. Sections 12 and 13 of the canoe trail overlap the Allagash for nearly 90 miles from Chamberlain Lake to St. John's River at Allagash Village. Section 12 is a 41-mile paddle from Umbazooka Stream to the Umsakas Lake outlet to where Section 13 begins. And seen in the map from our Johnson Pond put-in, we join the designated Northern Forest Canoe Trail Section 12 in Chamberlain Lake before Lock Dam. Our 2 Indian Stream put-ins met Section 12 in Eagle Lake. Furs roamed by Native Abenaki Indians in search of food and furs, then in the 1980s by lumbermen in search of virgin timber for logs and pulpwood, the Allagash today is visited by the adventurous paddler seeking a deep backwoods experience in wilderness camping. Each day begins from your tent, a campfire breakfast, packing of tents, gear, and canoes, and then paddle northeast downstream to experience an assortment of streams, lakes, rivers, and whitewater. Remember, the Allagash flows northeast. Each day ends after 8 to 20 miles of sometimes challenging paddling, and all the while seeing an abundance of wildlife, from the majestic moose to our national bird, the bald eagle. We locate a campsite, prepare a campfire, set up tents, maybe a swim, enjoy a well-earned dinner, see a beautiful sunset, followed by campfire stories and tales of the day. Then comes a deep sleep in the Allagash Wilderness Waterway. The next morning, we continue our daily routine and look forward to the day's paddle and confronts. The Allagash Wilderness Waterway is rich in historical points of interest from those bygone eras. We explored the tramway that connects Eagle Lake with Chamberlain Lake and see the locomotives that ran between Eagle and Umbazookas Lakes in the early 1900s lumbering era. At Churchill Dam, preparing for paddling the 5-mile chase rapids in empty canoes, we left our gear with a park ranger who brought our bags to the end of Chase Rapids. 12 miles from Allagash Village, we ported the most incredible spectacle on the river, the 40-foot-high Allagash Falls, a thundering, boiling cauldron of power and beauty. A week or so later, after paddling 100 miles, we are at Allagash Village, where the Allagash River and the St. John River meet on the Canadian border. Indeed, paddling the Allagash is a bucket list of treasured memories. These remembrances are shared and made everlasting in the Ballad of the Allagash. This video was made by Frank Crosby as he interviewed Timothy Priest heading to the North Maine Woods Allagash Checkpoint. Tim has been on many wilderness paneling trips run by Linwood the Loon Parsons and his wife Betty. Timothy shares his reflections on Linwood and Betty and his North Maine Wood trips.
So I guess the question, Tim, then is tell me a little bit about what it's like to be on a trip with Linwood.
It's very, for one thing, it's very relaxing, and it's a complete escape for me, because I live in Boston in the city, so coming out here to the woods is actually very nice and relaxing. It's always an adventure. I'm known as the guy who likes to flip the boat, not on purpose, but I'm 4'7" for going swimming. So if you come with me, you better wear your life jacket. And Linwood always takes us out. It's always a first-class trip. And the nicest thing is that he's not only a guy, but he's my cousin. And it always feels more like a family outing than a professional trip. But he is a professional guide, so you do get that treatment. His knowledge of the woods is impeccable. We're going to be doing a little under 100 miles for this trip canoeing, and he'll know every inch of the way. We're going to stop and look at locomotives. We'll hit Throw Island, and we'll even do some rapids. And when we go to those, the rangers are going to take our gear. So you've been paddling with about 400 pounds worth of crap in your boat, and now all of a sudden you got a light boat and you're going down the rapids, and it feels like you're in a Corvette compared to muscling around the heavy canoe you've been doing for days. So I'm really looking forward to getting the escape, and it's nice spending time with my father and friends too. You really see what people's true personalities are when you get out here. Where you really see who's the trooper and who's not. And if you ever do anything like this, you just have to relax and go with the flow. If it rains, you're gonna get wet. If it's hot as hell, you're gonna get a sunburn. It's just the way it is. You just have to accept things as they come. And that's also part of the beauty and part of the challenge of it.
Have you ever seen Linwood do any poling? You're standing up on the trips?
In his younger days, he would stand up and go through the rapids. Now the only time he stands up is just to check the rapids. He's not quite as cocky as he used to be.
So tell us a little bit about the menu that you're expecting. Are you looking forward to the food?
Yeah, the food's always first rate. And he has all his coolers with names on different rivers that he's been on. And he has a list, and he knows exactly where everything is and what day it should be opened. So everything's frozen when he starts out the trip, and you don't open certain coolers for 3 or 4 days, so the meat stays frozen, you freeze the juices, and basically we really don't go on dry food until around day 5 is when you start running out of good meat.
Okay.
Like the last time we did this, our last meal was pickled eggs and sardines. But, and Betty's a great paddler, so whatever she lacks in size and strength, she makes up for in technique and skill. So she looks pretty effortless out there. And when her and Linwood are in the canoe together, they're just absolutely in sync. They don't need to talk, they just do it. And they make it look easy.
On a canoe trip to northern Maine, two of our group flipped their canoe in the middle of Holwood Pond. My friend John and I were nearby, and we quickly paddled over, tied a rope to the overturned canoe, and towed them to shore. An exhausting paddle that took nearly a half hour. My cousin Linwood, a Maine master guide, asked, "Why did you not rescue them?" My response was, "We did." The next day, for nearly 4 hours, 6 companions and myself under the tutelage of Linwood learned and practiced 2 types of canoe rescue scenarios. The next year, the same group of friends and I were paddling across Eagle Lake on the Allagash Wilderness Waterway. Suddenly, one of our canoes capsized in the middle of a 1-mile-wide lake. By the time we reached them, the 2 occupants were swimming holding onto their bags. Their tents, food, and other camping gear drifted nearby, all protected by dry bags. With hardly a word said, this group, who had practiced the canoe rescue 4 hours the prior year, immediately began their learned canoe rescue technique. When the rescuer canoe reaches the overturned canoers, the wet canoers position their canoe perpendicular to the rescue. Once the front end comes out of the water, the 2 canoers push the upside down canoe over the gunwale of the rescue boat. The rescuers assist by pulling the canoe over the gunwale. When the upside down canoe is balanced on both gunwales, the 2 rescue canoers turn the now empty canoe over. Picture the 2 canoes crossed together. They then gently slide the empty canoe back into the water. Both canoes are placed side by side, and the rescue canoers hold the 2 boats. Floating gear is put back into the canoe, and the trip continues.
Well, there comes Steve and Tim getting ready to run the outlet to the horrendous looking pulverizing machine called the Allagash Falls. And they're running the outlet rapids, the runout rapids. Not a bad job.
I've never had a problem really standing up in canoes. As long as nobody else is trying to do it at the same time. I'm going to go back to the Chase Rapids and have you do that.
Standing up, I'm coming. I'm going to go up it first.
Yeah, I got to think this would be really difficult going up rapids.
That you learn how to pull when you want to go home.
The pulling in action. I don't know. It's like those guys do on. Don't they pull those gondolas and.
Yeah, Venice.
Venice, right. The thing actions a paddle pretty good, too.
Yes, it does. That's why they do it in deep water. You can paddle up.
You can paddle?
Yeah, you can use it as like a kayak. There you go, yeah.
This Allagash Wilderness Waterway ballad was prepared from participants' memorable moments of expeditions guided by registered Maine master guide Linwood Parsons and his wife Betty. Without a doubt, the Allagash Wilderness Waterway rates as a gem of Maine's wilderness areas. The verses of this ballad are to the tune of Janis Joplin, "O Lord, Won't You Buy Me a Mercedes-Benz." O Lord, won't you buy me a big can of Benz? I'm out in the woods now, the flies never end. Got bitten all over, no help for my friends. O Lord, won't you buy me a big can of Benz? O Lord, won't you buy me a bed of my own? A mattress and box spring that's not on the ground. Last night I got bruises, I slept on a stone. O Lord, won't you buy me a bed of my own? O Lord, won't you buy me a roll of TP? Those baked beans of Betty's are getting to me. Been wiping with leaves till I got poison ivory. O Lord, won't you buy me a roll of TP? O Lord, won't you buy me a deputy's badge? We helped save two druggies at Little Allagash. Old Andy was naked and Tara was scared. O Lord, won't you buy me a deputy's badge? O Lord, won't you buy me no new waterproof gear? Dry bags became wet bags when we sank to our ear. We swam down the rapids chasing the beer. O Lord, won't you buy me new waterproof gear? O Lord, won't you buy me a few more good years to paddle with Linwood and Harry Mitt Beers, chase rapids with Karen without many fears. O Lord, won't you buy me a few good more years? O Lord, won't you buy me an instant campfire? No sawing of firewood, no stripping of bark, no pleading with Linwood or Harry to light it. O Lord, won't you buy me an instant campfire? Oh Lord, won't you buy me a brand new spruce paddle? Chase rapids are coming, excitement is high. Cross jaw, sweep, and a pry, till we all finish dry. Oh Lord, won't you buy me a brand new spruce paddle? Oh Lord, take me down to the Allagash now. Take me to the Northwoods, where the moose runs wild and proud, to see the eagle soar as they relax on the shore. Oh Lord, take me down to the Allagash now. Oh Lord, won't you buy me a Maine master guide to show us the Allagash in swagger and stride, and teach us canoe rescue and a loon landing wildlife bona fide. Oh Lord, won't you buy me a Maine master guide? Oh Lord, won't you buy me a chickadee and a loon, the bread and the dead, Cornish hen and the coffee can, Folger's silk and a pudding lid spoon. Oh Lord, won't you buy me a chickadee and a loon? Oh Lord, won't you buy me a campsite to rest, spruce gum for the rookie, counting moose at its best, a swim through the rapids, flint and steel for our test. Oh Lord, won't you buy me a campsite to rest? Oh Lord, Lord, won't you buy me a long lake dam, a dam to portage if you can, or paddle at risk and I'll be damned, Tim and Steve paddled be damned. Oh Lord, won't you buy me a long lake dam? Oh Lord, won't you buy me some rapids right now? The V through the rocks will guide us somehow. The draw stroke shall save us with a quick turn of the bow. Oh Lord, won't you buy me some rapids right now? Oh Lord, won't you buy me more beer to help me create more cairns made of stone, and the whistles of willow and the white birch bark stars, so much more to create. So, oh Lord, won't you buy me more beer? Oh Lord, won't you buy me a big old white sail? I'm on Eagle Lake and the wind never fails. My arms ache from paddling. Oh shucks, is that hail? Oh Lord, won't you buy me a big old white sail? Oh Lord, won't you buy me a big old fat fish? I'll gut him and skin him, then he'll land in my dish. An 18-inch brookie, now that'll be my wish. Oh Lord, won't you buy me a big old fish? Oh Lord, won't you buy me a bigger canoe? 'Cause the one I have now just simply won't do. Need more room for the beer for the hard-stroking crew. Oh Lord, won't you buy me a bigger canoe? Oh Lord, won't you buy me? Paddle is so grand. Dundee is prepared and navigates firsthand. Timothy's skilled in the stern. When the river gets tough, he ensures the turn. Oh Lord, won't you buy me some stars in the sky? They look near at hand, yet are so high. I'm just a lightning bug seeking a mate in the heavens above, but I'm feeling spry. Oh Lord, won't you buy me some stars in the sky? Oh Lord, won't you buy me? Never say I wish I had. For 8 days we were in awe of the Allagash and the loon. Our skills grew as we paddled in tune. Coolers with names of rivers, all a lifetime of memories delivered. Oh Lord, won't you buy me? Never say I wish I had.